In a major setback for Sri Lanka, the United Nations Human Rights Council has adopted a resolution against Colombo's record on human rights. At least 22 out of 47 member nations voted in favor of the resolution. Which side did New Delhi choose? We tell you in a bit. Let's first discuss the resolution itself. Titled Promotion of Reconciliation, Accountability and Human Rights in Sri Lanka, this resolution calls upon Colombo to ensure a thorough and impartial investigation into all alleged crimes related to human rights violations. For the sake of context, the calls for a resolution began after the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights released this report that is now on your screen. This report warned that Sri Lanka is at the heightened risk of human rights violations being repeated. It talked about increasing militarization of governmental functions, ethno-nationalist rhetoric, intimidation of the civil society, and obstruction of justice for those on trial for war crimes. After much deliberation, members of the UNHRC gathered to vote on Tuesday afternoon. The results are as follows. Out of the 47 member nations, a total of 22 voted in favor of the resolution. This includes the United Kingdom, Canada, and Germany. 11 voted against the resolution. This includes Bangladesh, China, Pakistan, and Russia. 14 countries abstained from voting. This includes Nepal and India. And this is where things get interesting. Not only did India abstain, but it also urged Sri Lanka to carry forward the process of reconciliation, engage with the international community to ensure fundamental freedoms and address the aspirations of the Tamil community. Listen to this.
India believes in the primary responsibility of the states for the promotion and protection of human rights and constructive international dialogue and cooperation guided by the principles and purposes of the UN Charter in support of such efforts. As an immediate neighbor, India has contributed to the relief, resettlement, rehabilitation, and reconstruction process in Sri Lanka after 2009. Our development assistance has focused on the restoration of livelihoods and economic revival, especially in Sri Lanka's northern and eastern provinces. Madam President, India's approach to the question of human rights in Sri Lanka is guided by two fundamental considerations. One is our support to the Tamils of Sri Lanka for equality, justice, dignity, and peace. The other is in ensuring the unity, stability, and territorial integrity of Sri Lanka. We have always believed that these two goals are mutually supportive and Sri Lanka's progress is best assured by simultaneously addressing both objectives.
Let's now tell you what will happen next. Under the UNHRC resolution, one, the Sri Lankan government will be asked to ensure an impartial investigation into all human rights crimes. Two, the UNHRC will enhance its monitoring of the human rights situation in Sri Lanka. Three, the Office of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights will advise and assist the Lankan government in implementing its suggestions. And lastly, it will present an update at the Council's 48th session. But that's not the end of our Sri Lanka story. Here's something else you must know. Colombo has signed a $1.5 billion currency swap deal with Beijing. This deal has been signed for a period of 3 years. The signatories include the Central Bank of Sri Lanka and the People's Bank of China. Under this deal, Colombo is entitled to a $1.5 billion currency swap facility from Beijing, meaning it can borrow money for the same kind of interest and other rules that apply in Sri Lanka. Now, here's the thing. We all know that Chinese loans are rarely driven by benevolence, and the timing of this agreement only adds to our doubts. Sri Lanka is being cornered globally for human rights violations, and Beijing has sensed an opportunity to pull Colombo closer through money. We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.